How then may one build character? The first step in character building is rigid self-discipline. In both the second and eighth lessons of this course, you will find the formula through which you may shape your character after any pattern that you choose. But I repeat it here, as it is based upon a principle that will bear much repetition, as follows. First, select those whose characters were made up of the qualities which you wish to build into your own character, and then proceed in the manner described in Lesson 2 to appropriate these qualities through the aid of auto-suggestion. Create, in your imagination, a council table and gather your characters around it each night, first having written out a clear, concise statement of the particular qualities that you wish to appropriate from each. Then proceed to affirm or suggest to yourself, in outspoken audible words, that you are developing the desired qualities in yourself. As you do this, close your eyes and see, in your imagination, the figures seated around your imaginary table in the manner described in Lesson 2. Second, through the principles described in Lesson 8 on self-control, control your thoughts and keep your mind vitalized with thoughts of a positive nature. Let the dominating thought of your mind be a picture of the person that you intend to be, the person that you are deliberately building through this procedure. At least a dozen times a day when you have a few minutes to yourself, shut your eyes and direct your thoughts to the figures which you have selected to sit at your imaginary council table, and feel, with a faith that knows no limitation, that you are actually growing to resemble in character those figures of your choice. Third, find at least one person each day, and more if possible, in whom you see some good quality that is worthy of praise, and praise it. Remember, however, that this praise must not be in the nature of cheap, insincere flattery. It must be genuine. Speak your words of praise with such earnestness that they will impress those to whom you speak. Then watch what happens. You will have rendered those whom you praise a decided benefit of great value to them, and you will have gone just one more step in the direction of developing the habit of looking for and finding the good qualities in others.